Okay, we can start. So, okay, for today, I want to talk you with you about optimizing containers usage. So, let's try to optimize something new. What is a program? Program is data plus algorithms. So we don't work with raw data. We work with algorithms and containers. So let's optimize containers. Why we want to optimize containers? Okay, we are all in every situation use proper container because we are C++ experts here, all of us. But sometimes some of our C++ devs are not so clever as we. And possibly we can optimize a little bit more. You can say compilers are so clever today, and I shouldn't think about such stuff. But they're clever only s such in such situations like division by three. It's not nothing about about containers. So if you want to know want to understand how this works, please read these links. That's a terrible implementation, but by the way, not out of scope. So, my some observations. Compilers probably can optimize our algorithms, different optimizations, peephole, loop fusion, few weeks ago all of them got it, and anything else. But what about containers? Nothing. Definitely nothing. I'm not talking about reduced allocation and similar stuff. So, one example. We have two functions, foo and bar, and which is faster? Choose your fighter, and please, one, two, three. That's easy. So a bar is much faster. They are really equal, except one thing. Vector makes dynamic allocations. Tut array don't do it. Doesn't. So compilers cannot optimize this stuff. Only Clang in such simple cases, but not for std vector yet. I didn't test this MSVC. I don't care about this compiler. So more examples. Sorry for some examples. We can optimize std list for std forward list because of memory consumption issue. DAG for two stack or queue because of some mental model for us. If we don't use some DAG operations, vector to std list, so it's a little bit dangerous, but we can. And as I shown before, std vector to std array eliminate a lot of dynamic allocations. More examples, please send to me. Let's try to fix it. Use a Clang static analyzer. It's a open source, great static analyzer, big browsers, Clang tidy, a lot of integrations with IDE and so on. Let's do it. What should we do? Simple check. Walk over AST, collect all STL containers declarations, collect all operations, do some analysis, and suggest a proper container. That's easy. Not so. Because it's very limited to STL containers. More containers, more work. We can analyze only in function scope because of different issues between translation units and so on, and many other issues. How to improve? Use another analysis techniques like symbolic execution, and probably the most important, use dynamic analysis like profile guide optimization. If you want to improve this checker, please send the pull request on this link. Please before read this book about LLVM. And when we implement this, finally, and we can bring it to LLVM, I hope should be like this. Okay, a little bit more useful links, some related works for Java, for Python, useful books, and so on. And thank you.